Hello, Raiden community. In May of 2022, we deployed Raiden Protocol on Arbitrum 1. Many of you requested a tutorial on setting up a full Raiden node on Arbitrum testnet, and we are here to guide you through this process. Why set up a Raiden node on Arbitrum versus Ethereum mainnet? And what are the additional advantages over existing average optimistic rollups? Let's take a look at our table to answer those questions. As you can see, there is no difference in features, and the main advantage of using Raiden on Arbitrum is lower setup costs. It is also the better option for recurring micro transfers, comparing it to average optimistic rollup alternatives. This is worth keeping in mind when choosing the network you want to run your node on. Typically, end users prefer the fastest and cheapest solution for their recurring micro transfers, which in this case is using Raiden on Arbitrum. In this video, we will interact with two Raiden products, the Light Client CLI and the Light Client DApp. Let's discover what those are and how they differ from each other. The Light Client CLI and the DApp are very similar. They have the exact same protocol implementation under the hood, which is the Raiden Light Client SDK. The first difference is how they can be run. CLI runs in the terminal on your computer, or a VPS. The Raiden DApp is a wallet-like application running in your browser tab. The other difference between them is functionality. The Raiden Light Client DApp is a fully functional product that can be used for sending and receiving transfers. On the other hand, the Light Client CLI allows you not only to make transfers, but also mediate transfers and receive mediation fees from it. Therefore, if you are interested in accessing the full potential of Raiden, we highly encourage you to set up a Light Client CLI node. This tutorial is meant to guide you step by step. We will set up the Light Client node using our CLI with our new web UI. In the end, we will also demonstrate the transactions between two different wallets using the DApp and the Light Client node to showcase the possible interactions between both products. While the setup of the node itself takes under 4 minutes, we decided to include preparation steps to make the tutorial accessible to users with different backgrounds. We will cover the very basic steps, so feel free to jump to the relevant timestamps for you. Head over to the Chrome Web Store, search for MetaMask, and install it. Click the extension icon to proceed with creating an account. For the video, we're creating a new wallet and setting up a password, but you can use your existing account. If you are new to the blockchain, we strongly encourage you to watch the video about securing your account. In the next step, MetaMask will offer you a seed recovery phrase that we will later export as a JSON file, so you can store it safely. In the field, input your seed recovery phrase in the same order. And we're done creating our account. Our next step will be creating a JSON file. Now we will be converting the seed recovery phrase into JSON KeyStore file format. This step is important because it is the format accepted by the Light Client CLI. For this step, we need another extension. Go back to the Chrome Web Store, search for MewCX, and install it. From here on, the process is pretty straightforward. We need to add a new wallet and import the account we created in the previous step. Select mnemonic phrase and paste or type the secret recovery phrase you got during the last step. Select the first address from the list and double check to see if it's the same as your MetaMask account. add a name, and create a password. Note that this is a password solely for the JSON file, so ideally, it should be different from your MetaMask password. In the new window, you will see your newly created account. Select three dots and click on Backup to get the JSON file downloaded. All right, now the JSON file is secure. Now we can get you some testnet Ether. In this step, we will get RinkB testnet Ether from the faucet and bridge it to Arbitrum RinkB testnet. Test networks are not displayed by default in MetaMask, so we need to turn them on. Go to MetaMask and click on the list of networks. Then click Show Hide Test Networks. Find Show Testnets and turn it on. Now select RinkB Testnet from the list. Now we can search for the RinkB faucet in the browser. And let's go with the first option. Paste your MetaMask wallet address here to get 0.1 RinkB ETH. Great. Now we can check the transaction. Meanwhile, let's search for Arbitrum Public Testnet to find Arbitrum Dev Center. Here you can see the information and data to connect to Arbitrum RPC, but we will do this later. For now, let's go to the Arbitrum Bridge and send our test Ether from RinkB to Arbitrum RinkB Testnet. Let's connect MetaMask and agree to the terms of service. You can see our balance loaded, and now we can transfer, say half of what we have to RinkB Arbitrum. Confirm the MetaMask transaction. The transaction is pending, and it'll take around 3 minutes to be confirmed on Arbitrum. Now that we have the Ether wallet funded and the JSON file containing the secret phrase downloaded, we're ready to install and run Raiden CLI. There will be several lines of code in the following videos. They are added to the description of the video for your convenience. Start by opening the command line or terminal. To install, you can use yarn. In this case, we have Node.js 16 and yarn 1.22. And we use yarn global to add CLI to global path. You may need to add yarn path to your local path for Raiden command to become available. Now use --- help option to see the list of common line parameters accepted by the Raiden command. To start it, use data dir to specify the directory to save the database. Let's go back to the Arbitrum Dev Center in the browser and copy the public testnet endpoint URL. And for the Keystone path, you can use the download folder where our JSON file is stored. Also enable the Web UI administration interface. Here you can see the accounts that are found. Select the account, type enter, and use the password you set for the JSON file. So that's it. You will see that the client starts syncing and will download any available data from the blockchain. It can take up to 2 minutes to sync on your first start, but it should be faster going forward. If you want to speed up the process, instead of using a public endpoint from Arbitrum Rinkeby, you can create an Alchemy account and import the RPC endpoint from there, and use it with the Raiden CLI. Now that your node is synced, open a new tab in the browser and launch http://localhost:5001. In the tab, you can see the web UI running on top of Raiden Lite Client CLI. Now we can proceed to set up the Lite Client dApp so we can demonstrate transfers between two accounts. This tutorial showcases CLI plus Web UI acting as the first wallet and the dApp as the second one. Let's add endpoint RPC Arbitrum to your MetaMask networks. Go back to DevCenter in the browser and copy the RPC URL. Open MetaMask, click on the list of networks, and add a new network. Give new network a name, Rinkeby Arbitrum. Then paste the info from the Dev Center, RPC URL, chain ID. Add currency symbol, and we used ARB ETH. And lastly, add Block Explorer. As you can see, our Ether is bridged. Now we start using the Lite Client dApp. Go to https://lightclient.raiden.network. Let's accept the terms and conditions and connect MetaMask to Arbitrum Rinkeby network that was just created. Sign the message in MetaMask. It generates a subkey derived from your existing account to use on Raiden. This will allow signing signatures much faster than MetaMask, asking you to confirm each simple transaction. Let's wait a little for everything to sync. Now that both CLI and dApp are up and running on our browser, we will show how easy and fast it is to make transactions using Raiden on Arbitrum. Let's start by adding a new test TKN token. Let's use this token for our tests. Also, we need to deposit and mint some service tokens to fund UDC, user deposit contract used by Raiden Monitoring Service, the analog of Lightning Network watchtowers. This service will act on your behalf if you go offline and claim the fee for its services in tokens that we are minting now. The dApp node will, by default, refuse to receive transfers if you don't have a UDC deposit because it wouldn't be safe to go offline. Let's copy and paste the address of our full node from localhost. Let's mint some of those test tokens as well and make a deposit. Now we are opening a channel between Light Client DApp and the full client CLI and depositing 0.5 tokens. Now that the channel is opened, we can paste the address to perform a transfer from Light Client DApp to Full Node CLI. Select an amount to transfer. It is a direct transfer because we've just opened the channel with this peer. If you switch to the web UI on the localhost tab, you will see that the transfer has arrived on our Full Node client. In the same way, let's do a transfer from CLI to DApp. Copy the address of the DApp account and perform a transfer of the same token. It is the address of the Light Client DApp that we have opened from a different tab. And that's it. You can see that the transfer has just arrived. As you can see, the full node is running in the terminal, and you can manage it from the localhost browser page since we have web UI. And you can open DApp and connect it to the full client and make direct transfers between each other. Thanks for watching the video. I hope that we have answered all of your questions. Don't forget to like and subscribe. We also have tech and community support members who would be happy to help. Just head over to our Discord and reach out. There's a Discord invite link and other links to our official social channels in the description. Have a nice day.